صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك المعصومين الأبرار الميامين المظلومين المضطهدين صلى الله عليك يا مولاي وابن مولاي يا أبا عبد الله غريب يا غريب يا مظلوم يا عطشان كربلاء يا رحمة الله الواسعة ويا باب نجاة الأمة يا عبرة كل مؤمن وكل مؤمنة لعن الله الظالمين لكم من الأولين والآخرين ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمنا من لجأ والتجأ إليكم يا ليتنا فيا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي معكم لا مع غيركم فنفوز والله فوزا عظيما يوم من الأيام قد دخل الحسنان على رسول الله فأجلس الحسن على فخذه الأيمن والحسين على فخذه الأيسر أمسك الحسن وضمه إلى صدره وقبله في فمه One of those days الحسن الحسين They were with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. They were only children. Rasulullah made al-Hasan sit on his right side. He made al-Husayn sit on his left. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi took al-Hasan, grabbed him from his chest, brought him close. And kissed him on his mouth. ثم أمسك الحسين إلى صدره وقبله في نحره الشريف. فتوجه الحسين إلى أمه فاطمة يا وقال يا أمه يا أمه إن جدي رسول الله قد قبل الحسن في فمه وقبلني في نحري فلماذا فعل هذا أي لماذا لم يقبلني في فميك أخي الحسن رسول الله. After kissing Al-Hasan on the lips, he pulled Al-Hussein close to him and he kissed him on the neck. Al-Imam Al-Hussein later turned to his mother after this event had transpired and he says, Ya Ummah, my mother, tell me my grandfather Rasulullah kissed my brother on the lips, but instead he kissed me on the neck. Why, mother, did he not kiss me on the mouth just like he kissed my brother Al-Hasan? التفتت فاطمة إلى الحسين وقالت اصبر حتى يأتي جدك فأسأله عن هذا. فاطمة الزهراء says, wait, my son, wait till your grandfather Rasulullah. Wait till my father Rasulullah comes and I will ask him about this. فانتظرت حتى أن أتى رسول الله وأتي أمير المؤمنين وجلس الحسن والحسين وهي معهم هؤلاء أصحاب الكساء. She waited until Rasulullah came. Al-Imam Ali alayhi salam also came, and then all five of them came and sat together. These are the Ashab al-Kisa, these are the people who were under the Kisa. التفتت فاطمة إلى أبيها قالت أبا أبا يا رسول الله الحسين يسألني أنك قبلته في نحره وقبلت الحسن في فمه. Oh, my father, Fatima al-Zahra says that my son, oh father, my son al-Hussein is asking me. He says that you kissed his brother al-Hasan on the mouth, but instead of kissing al-Hussein on the mouth, you kissed him on the neck. كان النبي مطرقا برأسه إلى الأرض رفع رأسه وقال بني يعز علي أن أخبرك بني فاطمة يا قبلت الحسن في فمه لأنه يقتل مسموما أي أنني قبلته في مكان تجرعه السم. Oh my daughter, Rasulullah, when he was asked this question of Fatima al-Zahra, his head was down, he could not raise his head. Finally, he looked at Fatima al-Zahra and he said, my daughter, how am I supposed to tell you the reason? But I kissed Al-Hasan on the mouth because when he dies, he will die from poison. He will die because he has been poisoned, and so I kissed him on the place that the poison was going to enter. وَقَبَّلْتُ الْحُسَيْنِ فِي نَحْرِهِ لَأَنَّهُ يُذْبَحُ مِنَ الْوَرِيدِ لَلْوَرِيدِ أَيْ أَنَّنِي قَبَّلْتَهُ مَكَانَ ضَرْبِ الصُّيُوبِ. I kissed Al-Hussein on the neck because he will die with his head cut from one end to the next. I kissed him on the neck because this is the place that the swords of the enemy are going to fall on the neck of Al-Hussein. أيواه وحسينا وحسينا. التفتت فاطمة مفجوعة مألومة صاحت أبا يا رسول الله الحسين يذبح من الوريد إلى الوريد. قال لها نعم يا بني يا فاطمة. Fatima turned to her father with tears in her eyes. She says, my son will be killed by his neck being cut from one end to the next, all by himself. Her father replied, yes, my daughter. وفي زمن خال مني ومنك ومن أبيه وأخي. It will be in a time when I am not there, you are not there, Fatima, Ali is not there, and his brother is not there. قالت فاطمة أبا يا ولدي ولدي يذبح من في زمن خال منا أبا يا من يندب عليه ومن يقيم مأتمه من ينوح عليه من يبكي. Father, my son Al-Hussein is going to die. He's going to be martyred. His head will be cut in a time that none of us will be there. So, yeah, oh my father, who will cry on Hussein? Who will mourn for Al-Hussein? Who will shed those tears for Al-Hussein? قَالَ لَهَا بُنَيَّ فَاطِمَةً سَيَخْلُقُ اللَّهُ شِيعَةً وَمُحِبِّينَ وَمُوَالِينَ يُقِيمُونَ مَأْتَمَهُ وَيَنْدُبُونَ وَيَبْكُونَ عَلَيْهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Oh my daughter, don't worry, Allah will create a Shia, Allah will create a community. They will cry for Al-Hussein, they will mourn for your son Al-Hussein until the day of judgment. قالت فاطمة أبا يا أبا بماذا نكافئ هؤلاء الذين يحيون مأتم ولدنا؟ قال رسول الله أنا أشفع لهم يوم القيامة. Fatima says, what are we going to give these people who mourn for our son Al-Hussein? What are we going to give them as a jaza, as a benefit? Rasulullah says, I will give them shafa'a and intercession on the day of judgment. قالت فاطمة وأنا أدخلهم بيدي إلى الجنة. Fatima says, I will take them with my hand and enter the Shia into the Jannah. ثم التفت الرسول إلى أمير المؤمنين وقال أنت يا علي ماذا تقدم لهؤلاء؟ رسول turned to علي ابن أبي طالب and he says, يا علي, what are you going to give to them? قال أنا أسقيهم من الحوض. ثم التفت النبي إلى الحسن وقال أنت يا حسن. قال الحسن أنا أعبر بهم على الصراط إلى الجنة. Rasul turned to Ali, Ya Ali, what are you going to give to these Shia who cry for your son Al-Hussein? Imam Ali alayhi salam says, I will give them water with my hands from Al-Kawthar. Rasul asks Al-Hasan, and you Al-Hasan, what are you going to give to these Shia, these people who mourn for your brother? Al-Imam Al-Hasan says, I will walk with them on the path that will lead them to Jannah. ثُمَّ التَفَتَ النَّبِيُّ إِلَى الْحُسَيْنِ وَوَجَدَهُ جَالِسًا جِلْسَةَ الْحَزِينِ قَدْ وَضَعَ رَأْسَهُ بَيْنَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ الشَّرِيفَتَيْنِ قال وأنت يا حسين. Rasul turned to Al-Hussein. He saw him sitting there in a very sad manner. His head had dropped between his knees. He would not raise his head. Rasul said to his grandson, O Hussein, what will you give to these Shia who shed tears for you, who cry for you? رفع الحسين رأسه وقال أما أنا فمن زارني زرتو أنا أحضرهم في مواضع ثلاث ساعة الموت وفي الاحتضار وفي القبر. Al-Hussein raises his head and he says, my grandfather, for those Shia who cry for me and mourn for me, when they come to visit me and remember me, I will visit them. I will visit them on three stages at the point of death. When the body is dying, I will come to them in the period of waiting after the soul has left. And when they are all alone in the grave, I will come to them. I will be where with. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم كتابه المبين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أرسلنا من قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. عظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم لمصابنا بسيدنا ومولانا ابن رسول الله وحجة الله على خلقه أبا عبد الله الحسين بن علي سيد الشهداء وغريب كربلاء. Brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase the blessing and the ajar and the jaza for you in these days, in the days of crying for Imam al-Hussein. And brothers and sisters, we have all become familiar with the mourning that we do in the days of Muharram. And we have all made it a tradition. And there are many people who question that, why is this such a big tradition? Why do we repeat this every year? What is the use of just shedding tears and remembering a period of history that is painful? There are many periods of history that are painful. There are many people who have lost their loved ones. Why do you persist in enlivening this mourning every year? And brothers and sisters, our answer is that the events of Karbala were like no other event. The events of what happened on the 10th of Muharram on Ashura, there is nothing like that in history, because there was nobody in history like al-Imam al-Hussein. There was nobody in history like the grandfather of al-Imam al-Hussein, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And because we not only cry for al-Imam al-Hussein, because these majalis, this aza, this remembrance is not surely just to shed tears. It is because we are remembering the legacy of al-Imam al-Hussein. We are remembering what he lived for. We are remembering what he stood for. We are remembering what he died for, what he sacrificed for. And brothers and sisters, it is incumbent upon us that just like we remember the message of al-Imam al-Hussein, we must in every way remember the message of all of the Imams, because it is the one and the same message. The death of all of our Imams is a great tragedy, and we have one Imam who is still with us alive, and he is with us today. He is with us in this aza and in this morning. They say that he visits many, many majalis all over the world. He travels, and he is with all of the Shia, all of the Muhibbin, the Muwaleen, all of those who love al-Imam al-Hussein. And we must continue to enliven this majlis. We must continue to remember al-Imam al-Hussein, because the method and the message of al-Imam al-Hussein is something that it will last forever. Brothers and sisters, our religion, our deen is alive today because of al-Imam al-Hussein. Everything we have, our aqaid, our sharia, our way of living is alive because of al-Imam al-Hussein. This musibah of al-Imam al-Hussein is not the same as any other musiba. In fact, a man named Abdullah ibn al-Fadl al-Hashimi. Abdullah ibn al-Fadl al-Hashimi once came to al-Imam Abu Abdullah Ja'far ibn Muhammad and al-Sadiq sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Yabna Rasulullah, why is it that the sadness and the musiba of Ashura is so great? Why is the musibah of Ashura so great that it even eclipses, it is even greater than the musibah of Rasulullah's death? Why is it so great that it is greater than the death of Fatima al-Zahra salamullahi alayha? Why is the musibah of Ashura, the pain of Ashura so great that it is greater than the death of al-Imam Ali and al-Imam al-Hasan as well? This is a question. It is in the books, in a book called Ilal al-Shara'i'. This riwayah is there of this man, Abdullah ibn al-Fadl al-Hashimi. He is talking to al-Imam Abu Abdullah al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, the reason Ashura, the day of al-Hussein, and they say that la yawm ka yawmuka ya al-Hussein, there is no day like your day al-Hussein, and that is true. And this, his grandson, Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, is saying, he's telling this man that Ashura is unique. And the reason it is unique, because in the beginning there were only five. The Ashab al-Kisa, they were five. They were Rasulullah, Fatima al-Zahra, Imam Ali, Imam al-Hasan, Imam al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi majma'in. The Ashab al-Kisa were tight, they were known. They knew, the people knew that they were one and the same. They were all from the same Nur, They were all the same people. They were all from the same blood, the same flesh, the same ruh, the same everything was there. So that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, when he died and he left this world, the people were in so much pain, but they turned to Al-Imam Ali, Sayyida Fatima, Al-Imam Al-Hassan, Imam Al-Hussein. They sought their condolences in these people, in the other four. When Fatima al-Zahra, salamullahi alayha, when she died, they turned, because of their pain, they turned to Al-Imam Ali alayhi salam and Imam Al-Hassan and Imam Al-Hussein. They sought their condolences in the other three. When Al-Imam Ali alayhi salam died and the people were pained and sorrowed, they turned to Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein. There was somebody there. When they wanted to be reminded of Rasulullah, they turned to the ones who were remaining still alive. When Al-Imam Al-Hassan died, they turned to Al-Hussein, because this is Shabih Rasulullah. This was the son of Rasulullah. And so in their pain, in their desire to feel and to feel closeness to Rasulullah, they turned to Al-Imam Al-Hussein. But brothers and sisters, on the battlefield of Ashura, on the battlefield of Karbala, on the day of Ashura, Al-Imam Al-Hussein is the last of Ashab Al-Kisa. He is the last one of the Khamsa who were remaining, so that when he died, the people had nobody to turn to. Yes, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, my grandfather Ali Zain al-Abidin was alive, but he was not alive to see Rasulullah. He was born after the death of Rasulullah. That's why the musibah of Ashura, the musibah of Imam al-Hussein at Karbala is so great, brothers and sisters. That's why the musibah of Imam al-Hussein, every year we put on these black clothes, brothers and sisters. We put on the black clothes. We shed the dam'a that comes out of our eyes. The tears that come out of our eyes are because the musibah of Al-Imam al-Hussein is such a great musibah. What happened on the day of Ashura is such a great event that sorrows us. And brothers and sisters, it is because of profound love for Al-Imam al-Hussein. Profound. People ask the Shia, why do you cry for al-Hussein? Why do you shed tears for al-Hussein? And the only answer that we can give is because we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. That love, brothers and sisters, is the purest form of attachment that you can have. You ask a child why they love their parent, or ask a parent, why do you love your child? What answer are they going to give? You cannot describe. You cannot put it in words why you love somebody. This is the love we feel for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It is something that cannot be forced with a sword. It cannot be something that you buy with money. That the love is a very powerful thing, and you don't know how to even express what the object of that love is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, which one of us can sit here and do justice to the character of Rasulullah, to say what Rasulullah was? All we can say is that we love him more than anything else after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why we shed the tears for Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Brothers and sisters, that mawadda, that love, is the purest form of worship that we are going to have. Quran says, and it commands Rasulullah, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمْ اللَّهِ. The words that Allah uses in this ayah, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. If you love Allah, Rasul, go tell them that if you love Allah, if you love Allah, تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونَ, then follow me. Follow the Rasul. يُحْبِبْكُمْ اللَّهِ, Allah will love you. Allah will show you the love. If you love Allah, follow me, follow Rasul. And what does Rasul say? حُسَيْنٌ مِنِّي وَأَنَا مِنَ الْحُسَيْنِ. أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ أَحَبَّ حُسَيْنًا. Hussein is from me and I am from Hussein. Whoever has loved Hussein, Allah will love them. If this is the words of Rasulullah, and the Quran is saying, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي, if you love Allah, follow me, then Rasul is saying, go love al-Hussein. Go love al-Hussein. Brothers and sisters, it is not just that we say we love. It is easy to say love, that I love something or I love somebody, but if you don't follow through, if you don't demonstrate it in action, those words have no meaning. The legacy of Karbala, the legacy of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, is that not only do we love him, but that we keep his legacy alive. We live like Imam al-Hussein, brothers and sisters. that we say that this tear that comes out of our eyes is not just today. كل أرض كربلاء وكل يوم عاشوراء. Every land is كربلاء for us. Every day is عاشوراء for us. Every moment we are remembering Rasulullah and the sacrifice of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. And brothers and sisters, it's because in Imam al-Husayn is the ibrah, the warning, the teaching, the example for all of us. They say إنه عبرة لكل مؤمن وكل مؤمنة. Imam al-Husayn is the ibrah, he is the teaching, the warning, the example for every mu'min and every mu'mina. That means that what he did on the plains of Karbala, that yes, we cry, but we learn from what he did. We live like he lived. We do and we sacrifice the way he sacrificed, and we learn. Not only that, brothers and sisters, but when we need some explanation, who do we turn to? When we need an answer, we are not smart enough to understand the Qur'an or explain the Qur'an. We are not smart enough to know what all the Sharia is and the rules of Allah is. So we turn, and the Qur'an tells us, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Go to the أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. Go to the أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ and ask them, and they will clarify if you don't know. Now the question is, if you look at this word dhikr, this word dhikr is very beautiful, brothers and sisters, and one of the alim describes that this word dhikr, it means anything that brings you to the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikr, remembrance of Allah, is anything that will bring you to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what dhikr is. Now, in the Holy Quran, you have many examples. And the Quran says, وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. Remember Allah, lots of dhikr, do lots of dhikr. But there are certain things that will bring you, وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ. There are many things that will bring you, the Quran itself will bring you to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَدْ أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكُمْ ذِكْرًا رَسُولًا يَتْلُو عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ مُبَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. O you who people who want to excel, he says, Allah has sent to you ذِكْرًا رَسُولًا. Not only is the Qur'an a dhikr, but your Rasul is a dhikr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi with the ulama, and these are not my words, I'm transmitting to you what the ulama say, that Rasul is a dhikr. And how appropriate that who better to remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Who else to remind you of the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? Everything Rasul did was to remind us that قُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ تُفْلِحُوا. Say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ and you will be in success. Everything Rasul did. That's why Rasul is a dhikr. He brings you to the consciousness of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِيُخْرِجَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. So he can take the mu'mineen from darkness to light. Brothers and sisters, Rasulullah is a dhikr according to it, according to the Quran. But then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has also said, أولنا محمد, أوسطنا محمد, آخرنا محمد, وكلنا محمد. The first of us is Muhammad, the middle of us is Muhammad, the last of us is Muhammad, and we are all Muhammad brothers and sisters. So the Ahl al-Bayt, this Ahl al-Bayt of ours, Imam al-Husayn, Aba Abdullah al-Husayn, he is a dhikr for us. We are not just doing these majalis to shed vain tears. We are not just reading these majalis because we want to feel pity in our hearts. We are doing these majalis because in this tear, in this dam'a, in these tears, we are getting closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the very name of Imam al-Husayn is a dhikr that will take us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a learning, it is a ibrah for all of us. And we must use it as such, brothers and sisters. We know that he always reminded us that in every day, and we must make this a habit, brothers and sisters, that even when the 10 days of Muharram are done, Arba'een is done, we don't forget al-Imam Abi Abdullah al-Husayn, because he would say ana qatil al-habara, ana qatil al-habara, the sadness and the pain of my situation is so great, the sadness and pain of my situation is so great, ma min mu'minin dhakarani illa baka, there is no mu'min who will remember me and he cannot start crying, he cannot keep himself from shedding tears for me. I am so, the position in which I was is so painful. He says, Shi'ati kullama sharabtum al-ma uthkuruni. My Shia, he's talking to us brothers and sisters. Every time you take a sip of water, remember me. Say, Assalamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Drink that sip of water and say, Assalamu alayka to you, O the son of Rasulullah. You died 3 days thirsty on the plains of Karbala. Brothers and sisters, because in this, not only will we become educated, will we all become ulama, we will all become alim through the wasila of al-Imam al-Husayn, through the majalis of al-Imam al-Husayn, but we will become a part of them. Brothers and sisters, we want to be in the hizb of al-Imam al-Husayn. We want to be in the party of al-Imam al-Husayn. We want to be the supporters of al-Imam al-Husayn so that we can be in success like al-Imam al-Husayn. Brothers and sisters, on the Arba'een, on the day of Arba'een, when the events of Karbala and Ashura had ended, they described that a man named Atiyah ibn Sa'd al-Awfi came. Atiyah ibn Sa'd al-Awfi came and he was making his way towards Karbala. With him was a very old man. They described this old man was so old and so frail he could not walk very far, he would keep falling down. He had become blind from old age. This old man said to Atiyah, Atiyah, take me to these graves. I want to see these graves. One by one he went to the graves. Finally, Atiyah says, I took the old man and we came to the grave of the grandson of Rasulullah, Al-Husayn ibn Ali. We came to the grave of Al-Husayn ibn Ali, and this old man, he started to weep. He started to weep and he said, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, Habibun la yujibu ala habibin. Oh dear one, you don't answer the call of your dear who is calling to you right now. How can you? You are in the ground now all by yourself. 3 days thirsty, you are lying there. This old man is Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari. They describe the old companion of Rasulullah. When he faints and then Atiyah sprinkles some water on his face, Atiyah comes to. They describe, Atiyah says, Jabir lifts his head, he says, Assalamu alaykum, ayyatuha al-arwah allati halat bifina'i qabr al-Husayn wa anakhat birahlih, ashhadu annakum aqamtum as-salat wa ataytum az-zakat wa amartum bil-ma'roof wa nahaytum 'an al-munkar wa 'abadtum Allah hatta ataakum al-yaqin. Oh, I give my salam to you, Ya Hussein. I give my salam to you, Ya Hussein, and all the souls that died alongside Al-Hussein. I swear that you upheld the salat. You gave the zakat. You stood up for what was right, Ya Hussein. You fought against that which was wrong, Ya Hussein, until Allah took you away from this world. Tallah laqad bu'itha Muhammad bin nubuwati al-haqqa wa nahnu shuraka'akum fi ma dakhaltum. Jabir says, I swear that Allah sent your grandfather, Ya Hussein, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, with the true religion. And I swear that we are sharik with you in what you did. Jabir says, نَحْنُ شُرَكَاءَكُمْ فِي مَا دَخَلْتُمْ. We are participating with you. We participated with you, Ya Hussein, in what you did. Atiyah ibn Sa'd is now startled by this statement of Jabir. He is startled that how can you say that we participated with Al-Hussein? He says, كَيْفَ نَكُونُ شُرَكَاءَهُمْ وَلَمْ نَكُنْ مَعَهُمْ. O Jabir, O companion of Rasulullah, how can you say that we participated when we were not even here in Karbala? How can you say we were sharik in the act, in the sacrifice of Al-Husayn, if we really were not even present? Jabir answers, he says, Ya Atiyah, Sama'tu Rasulullah yaqul. I heard my Habib Rasulullah say, Ya Atiyah, Man ahabba qawman hushara ma'ahum, wa man ahabba amala qawmin kana fihi sharikan. Whoever loved Whoever loved a community, whoever loved what a community did, he automatically became a participant in their actions, brothers and sisters. The words of Rasulullah, these majalis is so that we can be participants with Al-Imam Al-Hussein on the day of Ashura. So that we can be with Al-Imam Al-Hussein, brothers and sisters. This is an expression of our love for Al-Imam Al-Hussein. And brothers and sisters, we are not alone in this. Fatima al-Zahra, salamullahi alayha, is with us. Wa Fatima, wa Fatima. Bint Rasulullah, the mother of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, is here with us. This is our expression of love to her father. This is our expression of devotion to her. This is our expression of loyalty to Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib. And brothers and sisters, it is something that we keep with us. يروي بسند معتبر عن الريان بن شبيب أنه قال دخلت على الرضا عليه السلام في أول يوم من محرم الريان بن شبيب describes that once الرضا علي بن موسى عليهما السلام came in to speak to him on the first day of Muharram. قال الإمام الرضا يا ابن الشبيب سرك أن يكون لك من الثوايا مثل ما لمن استشهد مع الحسين فقل متى ذكرته يا ليتني كنت معهم فأفوز فوزا عظيما. Al-Ridha says to Rayyan ibn Shabir, oh ibn Shabir, if you have the desire, if you want the blessing of those who died and were martyred with Al-Husayn at Karbala, then every time you take the name Al-Husayn, every time you say Aba Abdullah, say Ya Laytani Kuntu Ma'hum Fa'afuza Fawzan Azeema. Every time you take the name Al-Hussein, say, oh, that I could have been with them at Karbala. Brothers and sisters, we are saying this every day, that we could have been with Al-Imam Al-Hussein at Karbala. That we could have been supporting Al-Imam Al-Hussein, so that we could be in the success like Al-Imam Al-Hussein. يبن شبيب سرك أن تكون معنا في الدرجات العلا من الجنان. فحزن لحزننا وافرح لفرحنا وعليك بولايتنا يا O Ibn Shabib, if you want the highest of stations and you want to be amongst us in the highest of stations and you want to be in the biggest of gardens in the Akhirah, then you must be sad for anything that we are sad for. If anything makes us happy and pleases us, you must be pleased. And you must make sure that you take our wilaya and our guidance. Ya Ibn Shabib. They say that Al-Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam turned to Rayyan ibn Shabib. He says, Ya ibn Shabib, in kunta bakiyan bi shay'in fa abki lil Husayn ibn Ali. فإنه ذبح كما يذبح الكبش وقتل معه من أهل بيته وريان وابن شبيب. If you weep for anything, if you cry for anything, if you feel sorrow for anything, then feel sorrow for my grandfather Al-Husayn ibn Ali, because he was slaughtered just like the animals are slaughtered. And with him were his family, his Ahl al-Bayt. وَلَقَدْ بَكَتِ السَّمَاوَاتِ السَّبْعِ وَالْأَرْضُونَ لِقَتْلِهِ. The skies cried for Al-Husayn. The earth cried for Al-Husayn. وَلَقَدْ نَزَلَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَ لِنَصْرِهِ فَوَجَدُوهُ قَدْ قُتِلِ. Even the angels came down from the sky, O Ibn Shabib, to give him support. But by the time they had reached the ground, they found that the head had already been split from the body. فَهُمْ عِنْدَ قَبْرِهِ شُعْثٌ غُبْرٌ إِلَى يَقُومَ الْقَائِمُ فَيَكُونُونَ مِنْ أَنصَارِهِ وَشَعْرَائِهِ. On that day, they will remain at the grave of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, disheveled and in sorrow, until the Qa'im from the Ahl al-Bayt, Al-Imam Al-Mahdi, makes his appearance and seeks his revenge. Ya Aba Saleh, Ya Aba Saleh. أكيد أنت تشاهد يا أبا صالح أكيد أنت تسمع يا أبا صالح أكيد أنت اليوم مشغول بمصيبة جدك الحسين. Oh our Imam, you are with us today. You are with us today, يا الإمام المهدي, seeing that we are shedding tears for your grandfather al-Hussein. Take our hands, allow us to be of your supporters, brothers and sisters. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم إن الله إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون سيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أي منقلب ينقلبون ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون باسمك العظيم الأعظم العز الأجل الأكرم يا الله أنت عز يا الله 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 اللهم إنا نسألك ونقسم عليك بحب الخلق إليك محمد أفضل الصلوات وأزكى السلام عليه علي وفاطمة والحسن والحسين والتسعة المعصومين من ولد الحسين فرج عنا يا الله بحق الحسين فرجا عاجلا قريبا كلمح البصر أو أقرب من ذلك ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وتوفنا مسلمين وارحمنا وعافنا وعافنا بحق محمد وآل محمد الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.